which deck to use for magic. Stick around and I'll tell you. Hi guys, my name is Anthony and welcome to my channel where we talk about magic, gaming, and digital art. Let's go! This is a question that I receive a lot from new magicians. What deck to use for magic? In this video, I'll attempt to answer that question, and this is all based on my opinion, what I have observed from other magicians, and from what I've researched as well. Let's go! This video is condensed wherein I only talk about three purposes of a deck of cards in magic. Depending on which purpose you have, or which purpose you want to use a deck of cards for magic, then that is the deck of cards that you'll use. Very easy. Let me explain. First is spectator familiarity. Do you want a deck of cards that look common, looks ordinary, looks like some sort of ordinary household object? That's one. The second one is comfort. Do you want a deck of cards that feels soft in your hands, that makes you easy to manipulate objects, that makes it easy to do sleights? So that's number two. And lastly, aesthetic. Do you want a deck of cards that shows your brand, shows who you are, shows the personality that what kind of magician you are, shows what you call this, the kind of person or your what kind of dress do you are? Do you want it to match your dress or your wardrobe? So that's the third, aesthetic. I'll explain further right now. First is spectator familiarity. If you're the kind of magician that wants to grab or go under your spectator and surprise them from behind, this deck is for you. A really common deck of playing cards wherein you can find this anywhere. You can find this at home, in the 7-Eleven, in the, I don't know, library, national bookstore, anywhere. Once you see a deck of cards lying around like that, you won't suspect anything. A normal spectator won't suspect anything with something like this. So when you naturally do magic with this ordinary object, it'll blow their minds. So yeah, if you're a person that says, okay, I want to be someone, I want to be a magician that blows people's minds using things that they see every day, then find a deck of cards that you can. That's very common. A good example is the bicycle playing cards. It's like, let's say, the untold standard of card magic, wherein most magicians use this deck of cards because it's very common, it's very easy to find, and it's the one that has been used for a long, long time in magic. So you can't go wrong with this kind of playing cards. So yeah, that's the first one, spectator familiarity. The second one is a bit different. Basically, it's comfort. Now, what kind of magician are you? What kind of card magician are you? Are you like a card mechanic? Because if you're a card mechanic, you need a deck of cards that is thin, that is soft, that's easy to glide, and has a design wherein that hides all your sleights. Are you that kind of magician? Comfort. Or are you like a cardist? A cardistry artist, a cardist, wherein you need thicker cards so that you can do those different moves, different cuts. So that's the second one, comfort as well. Now, are you a magician that have very sticky hands? Do you need a different card stock that doesn't absorb too much water? That's another one, comfort. So depending on what kind of magician are you, if you want to pull off the hardest sleights, the hardest moves with ease, you have to find the deck of cards that fits your hand. So comfort. Now, there's some magicians that like smaller cards, bridge cards, plastic cards. If you feel that you're able to pull off different moves or improve your magic with the comfort of the tools that you use, then find a deck that's like that. A good example are plastic cards. A good example are like just a regular, $2 playing cards that you can find in the store. They're thick, some are thin, some are easy to glide, and some really work. I know a cardist from a magic club that uses some sort really thin cards because he's able to pull off some different kinds of legendary deals. So yeah, find a deck of cards. If you're a kind of magician that wants to pull off different moves that are so difficult, you need to have the tools that provide you with that comfort. So if you're like that, find a deck like that, comfort. And lastly, aesthetic. Now, are you a magician that wants to portray a message, to give a message, to give some sort of statement to the magic community and to the normie communities out there? Then find the right aesthetic for the certain from a deck of cards that can fit that personality. Are you like very summery or very bright? Then you have a summer deck. Or if you're like someone who's like very, very dark, very mysterious, find a monarch deck. Or someone who dresses like that. Basically, an aesthetic deck is where magicians want to be individualized. Do you want to be someone who individualizes from other magicians, to be separated from them? Then find a deck of cards that proves that message. If you're that kind of magician, then a deck for magic for you is something that is a custom deck. Any custom deck will do. Like I have here the Summer Knock deck, playing cards. This is orange, pure orange, all orange. So if you're a kind of person that's jolly, that's cheery, there you go. If you're someone that's like mysterious, someone very dark, something like the Now You See Me people, then yeah, Monarch playing cards are for you. Any aesthetic, any card design. Now, I don't only mean by the backs, I also mean by their faces of the cards, by the way they look, their different colors. If you're a magician that can pull off, hey, and how to explain an orange colored Queen of Hearts, if you can pull that off, then why not? If that's your style, if that's how you want your cards to be, there you go. If your purpose for is aesthetic only, how it looks, how good it looks in front of others, how you want to see the cards flow through your magic aesthetically, pleasingly, then aesthetic purpose, find a custom deck of cards for yourself. So that's the best deck of cards for you. You might ask me, Anthony, what kind of deck of cards do you use? I'm glad you ask. Basically, I grew up in a more of a cardist environment when it comes to playing cards. I do cardistry, and I, at the same time, I also do actual magic. But now, as I grow older in magic, I move to a more condensed style wherein I just tend to not do too much flashy. Flashy moves, cardistry moves are great for practice to warm up the hands. But when I want to perform for someone, I want to lay low, to grab them from behind and surprise them. All right. So anyway, what cards do I use for that? I need something that fits any of the three, or mostly hits all three. Well, I can find the deck of cards, but I have here a custom deck of cards. It looks kind of wonky, but this design is, if you put three deck of cards together, it forms a half of a jumbo card. This is called the Anjot deck. It's designed by myself and my partner, Almerly Joy Putong. We designed this deck of cards. Hence, it's a very simplistic, very bright color red. There you go. It's A and J. Very inspired by the Fontaine series, wherein this card, the red Fontaines is one of the rarest decks in the world. And I can't afford a Fontaine. I can't find one. Even in eBay, it reaches, I don't know, 500 now? Was it 500 now? I can't afford that. So I said, well, I'm very inspired by how it is, but I want to have my own flair to it. So this is what we got, the Anjot deck. Very simple, and it's also very, very easy, very smooth, and I really like it. There you go. Now, when it comes to, it touches aesthetic, because it's very simple, very clean, great for cardistry, great for magic. Now, when it comes to spectator familiarity, this one, I just designed the back. The front, oh my God, the front is so common. You can see all the nothing change, very common. It's a deck, Ace of Spades, all those different, nothing out-colored, nothing different from the faces of the cards. So although the back is very unique, the faces of the card are just the same. So a bit of that, a bit of spectator familiarity. And for comfort, as I said, I grew up from a cardist background. I do a little bit of cardistry now and then. I do a little bit of this. And so I need a card stock that's a bit thicker so that when I do something, do some cardistry stuff, it won't break or it grips in my sweaty fingers. So it's very reminiscent to the original Dan and Dave cardstock, the smoke and mirrors one, where it's very thick and it's easy to cut, to make cuts with it. And that's what I tried to replicate in this deck. I admit it's not the same quality as the Dan and Dave one, but this comes damn close and I really like that. I like the gloss. And side note, I like the glossy little feel of it. So anyway, what deck do I use? I use the Anjot deck. Now, I use this one for slights because I would like to do slights. But obviously, if I wanted to do something more special with different cards, gaff cards, I use the original, let's say, bicycle playing cards. Yeah, but anything else, I use my deck of cards because they, in my opinion, they're really nice, elegant to use, and they're eye-catching when I actually spread it apart like that. So yeah, that's the deck that I use. So that's it. That's how I answer your questions. Basically, which deck to use in a deck of cards, I summarize it into three purposes. What kind of magician are you, and what purpose do you use the deck of cards? So You can use it for spectator familiarity, use it for comfort, or use it for aesthetic. And whichever purpose you use it for, that's the there's a subgroup of deck of cards within that that can help you. I hope you like this little video. I hope I answered that question. And if you want to have more questions with regards to what deck of playing cards I use or what do we have here, don't forget to comment below. And I'll try to answer all of them. Once again, guys, thank you very much for tuning into my videos. Thank you very much for reaching the end. I know it was just answering questions and then a little plug of my custom playing cards. But it's the same. Thank you very much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. And thanks for tuning in. Thanks for coming back. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much. So don't forget to click that thumbs up button and smash that subscribe button. That really helps me a lot. So yeah, hope you enjoy this. Until next time.